Nathan, how's the mood in the dressing room after you got over the line in the week against Blackpool?
No, I'd say it's good. I feel like we're quite a level-headed team anyway. So we've got good characters to, like, you know, when we lose and maybe not playing well. It keeps it quite level-headed. So, yeah, we're good. Ready to go again. Looking forward to it.
Russell Martin told us that actually the players weren't that happy after Blackpool.
Yeah.
I don't know, perhaps because of the way the game went in the last half hour, but he did say that you came in and told everybody to cheer up.
Yeah. Yeah, because I thought, like, yeah, we weren't at our best, like, part of the second half, but there's been many times this season where we've dominated and we haven't come out with a win, and I feel like we won, so, like, I know you got to reflect on the performance because that's what's, in the long run, what matters, because the more good performances you have, the more results you're going to get. But I felt like we've come off 3 points, like, really, that's, who cares? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, it all comes down to the results, ultimately, doesn't it?
Yeah.
How hopeful are you that you can build on that Blackpool win and put a few results together now?
Yeah, that's the thing, because, like, when you lose a game, you're thinking, next one we have to win, but then when you win a game, it's like, no, we'll go on a run now, win the next one, then, like, see where that takes us. And it's much more, it's like, the mentality is different when you've won and you're going into the next one, you know. Look forward to it a bit more, and we're looking forward to Saturday.
You're such a young team, aren't you? I think, you know, on average, perhaps the youngest in the division over the season.
Yeah.
Do you think that's perhaps why the consistency has been a struggle for you at times?
Maybe, yeah. I mean, it's hard for me to comment because I haven't played in that many teams. So it's hard for me to say, oh, it's this, it's that, because I haven't got experience of noticing things in teams. But maybe it is that. But, you know, we're all learning and we'll be better for it in the future.
On a personal note, can you feel yourself progressing as a player with the regular exposure to first team?
Yeah, definitely, definitely. I think experiences, there's something you can't coach or you can't buy. It's like you can only get it by playing games, and I definitely feel like the more I've played, I don't know, it's hard to explain, but you just feel the feels all different. Like, you half know what to expect, and I am enjoying it as well.
Because it's not easy to play at the back in a Russell Martin team, is it? The way that you're asked to play, you can't just send it, you can't launch it down the channels, can you? I don't think the manager will be standing for that.
No, well, that's a good thing. Like, it helps you, it puts you in under precious situations to, like, get out of, and, you know, that's just going to help you be a better player. Sometimes you'll make a mistake, but making mistakes is part of life and part of, you know, getting better. So I love it, to be honest. I love playing under the pressure, because I just know that in the long run it's going to help me.
You go to Blackburn this weekend, a team around you in the table, another team with playoff ambitions. Do you feel like you can go there and get a result, though, on the back of the Blackpool win?
Yeah, definitely. I feel like we go into every game thinking we can win, without a doubt. I feel like it's about us as well. If we get our changing room right, I feel like we can beat anyone. And I believe that strongly. So looking forward to going there. And obviously the last game wasn't, I mean, we've all come a long way since then, especially, I feel like, me personally as well. So I'm looking forward to putting it right and, you know, seeing, feeling how much different we are as a team and individuals on Saturday compared to the first home game of the season.
And as players, do you think the top six is still on this season?
Well, yeah, it's only 5 points or something like that, isn't it? I don't really look that much, but as long as you're, What's the word? I forgot the word. consistent.
Yeah.
As long as you're consistent, then, like we said, like, we won Wednesday night, it's about the next one. Get another win and then just take it game by game. Look for consistency and hopefully we're thereabout.
Morning, Nathan. Good to see you. You mentioned there you want to put that right. You said about the last game against Blackburn. It was a good performance on the whole, but a few mistakes in the scoreline looked really bad, but there was a lot of good positives in that. But what do you personally say you want to put right from that?
Just like, it's more like my mentality of the game. I remember I felt, I think it was only my second game as a Swansea player. I just felt on edge, especially quite like on edge in the second half. And I feel like now I've went through more of them situations, so I'm more experienced in, you know, dealing with state of the game. You know, if you're losing and you don't deserve to be losing, keeping your head on a, you know, level. And I'm just looking forward to the challenge because I know it will be a challenge. They're a good team. They've got good players in the pose of threat. So, I'm just looking forward to see how I cope with it, because last time I didn't feel personally I coped well with the situation of the game. So I feel like since then I've learned how to be better with things like that.
The manager's always said, even before you were here, when he first came in, that mistakes are going to happen, players will learn from it, certainly the young ones like yourself as well.
Yeah.
You feel you have learned a lot in that, what, 6 or 7 months since it's been... since
yeah,
that happened.
I feel like I've learned so much, yeah. I mean, especially with the teammates I've got and, you know, the staff around, like, we go into so much detail, and you're also free to be yourself and be authentic, and we go through clips and that, little details, and every single game is something. Like, you can win, like, when we win well or play well, there's always little things that maybe like your average fan wouldn't notice, but when you're in like this environment, like, it gets picked out and it makes you even better. So yeah, I've learned so much and it's been really good.
And in terms of, there's 7 more games now until the next international break, the last one of the season. Going into that with a win against Blackpool the other night must put you in a confident mood. But have you set any sort of targets for these small blocks? Obviously, the long term aim, you want to get promoted and playoffs and whatnot.
Yeah.
But in short term, how does it work in terms of looking at a small chunk of fixtures like this?
Like I said, I just think it's about taking each game as it comes. Or that's what I'm doing personally, I think. Because they come around so quickly at the minute as well. It's just about, you know, getting through each one and like trying to get the win and then going into the next one. You can't always get fixated on like, oh, we've got this 7-game block, we need to get this many points. Like, sometimes that doesn't always work for people and teams. So I just think at the minute it's just about being consistent and taking each game.
Top man. Thanks very much, Nathan. Cheers. Best luck for tomorrow.
Nice one. Cheers.